just really introduce the people in the band, because we really love each other a lot. So, on my far right, that gal over there, she started playing with us back in the 90s. She went to Mexico City with us. She went to Thailand with us, and then she went to Arkansas with us in Missouri, and we had a lot of adventures together, and a lot of places, and she plays every instrument. Kate plays keyboards, she plays drums, she plays violin, she plays bass, guitar. She's amazing, and she's a mom. She has 4 kids. She's fantastic. Kate Thompson. Give it up for Kate Thompson. The next guy on my right is my neighbor. We live in the same town together, a little town north of San Francisco called Fairfax. It's sort of the place where all the hippies go because there are no jobs. Tom started playing with us in the late 90s. We replaced James Gurley when James left the band. And Tom's been with us on and off ever since. We think he's one of the greatest guitar players in the world. We really do. This lady here, Eileen, started playing with us about 2 years ago in Catanzaro, Italy. She went with us, and we love her a lot. And the thing about Eileen, that really impressed me, that she just told me recently, was that we're all big baseball fans, and in the United States, it's a big honor to sing the national anthem. When a singer gets asked to sing the national anthem at a baseball game for a major league team, it's a big deal. Anyway, Eileen has sung the national anthem twice for the Tampa Bay Rays, and she's a fantastic singer. We love her. Anyway, she's our most recent addition. This guy here is the founder of Big Brother and the Holding Company. We've been together. Peter and I have been playing together for 50 years. Peter's been like the Beatles, you know. I was talking to Kate tonight. We have a sort of similar story. It's like Peter met Sam, and they formed this band, and then they found James, who was a guitar player, kind of like George Harrison. And then they had another drummer, and he was sort of like the Pete Best. And then they got rid of that other drummer and hired me, so I was like the Ringo. I came in sort of later. But anyway, we've been playing together 50 years, and this guy really is the guy who started the band and founded it and has been playing with it for 50 years, Peter Albin.
That's Dave Getz. We found him working, he was playing drums upstairs to a restaurant I used to go to, and we were looking for a drummer, and I heard him practicing all the time. I said, he's better than our drummer. I upstairs, introduced myself. But he's from Brooklyn, New York.
So is Eileen.
And Eileen is from Brooklyn, too. Don't hold that against them, Anyway, he's been playing since he was probably like 12 or 13. Played a lot of jazz, played in the Catskills, of all places in New York, and was also an art instructor, and went to the San Francisco Art Institute and made salads at the Spaghetti Factory, which is a restaurant there.
Too much information.
Anyway, he's probably the oldest guy here in this room. Thank you.
A newer song, probably you don't know, but we've been doing this actually for about 15 years. It's called Save Your Love. It's kind of like a reggae. We'll do it.
For the dancers. at about 9.
All right, when we first started this band many years ago, we listened to a lot of records. We listened to the Beatles, of course, the Rolling Stones, Otis Redding. We used some of those songs in our set. But we also listened to a bunch of older records, things done by, songs collected by the, who were they? The Lomax family and some others. So this goes way, way back. This is like a, a religious gospel tune from, I think, the New Orleans area. It's called Blind Man.
Show me the way.
Now we're going to really get the dredge out and really go back, way back. This is a song that someone, a guy named Powell St. John, wrote for Janis back when she lived in Texas in the early 60s. It's called...
Bye Bye Me.
Oh, right.
It is.
Okay. Bye Bye Me.
Janis Joplin first joined the band, she brought in a number of songs, and this is one of them that she brought in. It's called The Turtle Blues. Hope you like it.